Magisters and paladins, all dead. Black Ring, could they be doing the purging?
The plot thinnens.
Thank you.
hard to fathom such magic, even when it's right.
A hulking black ring captain glares at you with his one eye, the other one a weeping socket surrounded by recent burn wounds.
You're no one of mine. You're not from headquarters either. Explain yourself, or I'll open you up and rip out an answer myself.
His blade is inching out of its scabbard, even as he speaks.
Almira, apologies, mistress. I'd never have dreamed of questioning any thrall of yours.
He bows and gestures for you to pass.
How we turn the world the Seven created against them. We drown their very temples with the oceans themselves. The God King will smile upon us.
That conjurer laid waste to an entire temple in an instant. After we bled ourselves dry trying to take it. Whatever reward that was coming to us is all for her now.
The Conjurer pays you no heed. She has eyes only for the portal swirling ahead under her control. It hungrily consumes the sea upwards like a waterspout. The captain tries to angle the blade of his sword to catch a glimpse of his injuries in its reflection. He winces at the damage before seeing you approach.
Mistress Almira, how can I be of service? But I can't, Mistress Almira. We have orders. The temple has to stay submerged. As you wish, Mistress Almira. Move out. On the double!
A saltwater crocodile looks around, seemingly disoriented. It spots you.
Where the water go? Why does my head hurt so much? The shore, yes. After a rest.
The crocodile slumps down and closes its eyes. The crocodile remains slumped where you left him, still...
My head!
Thank you.
If I'm to understand this correctly, it reads, walk safely in Vrogir's path. It looks like this place gave the Black Ring a bloody nose. Best be careful ahead.
The spirit of a Black Ring defiler frantically drags something, or someone, backwards with both hands. He glances around for help as he retreats. Something beneath his heel clicks.
Help! Somebody Dousifleur! Dousifleur!
A spectral arrow suddenly lodges itself between his eyes with a hollow thwack. His face turns slack and confused before he collapses backwards in a heap.
Careful! I've spotted a trap!
The spirit of a Black Ring witch flails and writhes on the floor, engulfed by ghostly flames. An unseen force hauls her backwards, as if to bring her to safety. The faint sound of an arrow being loosed echoes through the hall. Whatever force has been dragging the witch abruptly stops. She goes limp. The flames consume her.
Careful now, that's a trap. Look out! I see a trap nearby.
Spotted a trap!
An ancient-looking lever stands before you. It's still damp from the recently receded floodwaters. There's a small slot in the side of the lever, almost like a keyhole. A deep rumble heralds the wall beyond sliding downwards, a hidden door.
Careful now, that's a trap.
The spirit of a hulking armored figure angrily thrashes at the surroundings with a ghostly warhammer, to no effect. Between swings, you glimpse his face, that of an orc.
Dogs, skulking vermin, cowards.
He hurls the Warhammer away with a final yell before turning to you with a deep scowl, panting for breath that he no longer needs.
Godwoken, you're here. Did you kill the Black Ring runts who defiled Rogier's temple, who flooded this sacred temple rather than test me in battle? Only torture, dismemberment, no matter. Rogier's temple is restored. Those heretics cannot dull his might. This temple was a fortress. My traps made it untouchable, unpassable. That weasel, that sad old man, he responded not with strength, but with soggy cowardice that made me look the fool. Face me, you milk-livered mouse! Then earn your passage. Rogier does not reward the weak and wobbly. He cares not for your wits and wiles. He demands nothing less than the might of an ox and the brawn of a bear. Prove your strength and reap the reward, Godwoken. You will ascend and you will make these cowards pay. The world grew too civilized for us. No plunder, no glory, nothing to make our hearts quicken. My people left you to your cities and farms and soft beds. They went far in search of a place where they could be alive. But I am a knight of Verogia. I stand vigil. I do not know what became of them.
Careful. I've spotted a trap. Careful! I've spotted a trap. Look out! I see a trap nearby. Look out! I see a trap nearby.
The spirit of a Hulk.
Dogs.
He hurls the Warhammer away with a final yell.
Godwoken, you're here. Did you kill the Black Ring? Good. This temple was a fault. Then earn, prove your strengths, and reap the rule of the world. My. I am an.
Careful now, that's a trap. Careful, I've spotted a trap.
The spirit of the night prowls the chamber, spoiling for a fight. Kneeling before you is the spirit of a priest, an orc priest. He produces an ornate dagger and slices open the palm of his hand. Around him, a sound suddenly rises to a roar of rushing water.
Rogier, I am your servant to my last breath.
He daubs the altar with his spectral blood and bows. The roar of water intensifies. He is suddenly swept forward. His skull hits the altar with a crunch. The spirit of another orc stands before you, a priestess. She gapes at something looming high above her, approaching from the other side of the hall. She staggers back a few steps. An echoing roar fills your ears, rushing water. The priestess turns to flee, but is suddenly blasted off her feet by an immense, unseen force. The grim drip, drip, drip of flood water and the bloated body at your feet make this place feel more like a defiled tomb than a temple. Nevertheless, you approach the altar. Your vision clouds, and you open your eyes to a dark glade. Before you lies a bull, trapped beneath a fallen tree. It stares at you with malevolent eyes. As you watch, it transforms to a bear, claws digging into the earth as it struggles to dislodge the log. You blink, and it turns again, a gorilla now, its vaulted back pushing hard against the wood. After a few more minutes' struggle, it slumps to the ground, defeated, and its contemptuous eyes return to you.
Strength! Give me your vigor!
The god shifts shape again, contorting into a snake. Grimacing, you reach out your hand, and Vrogir sinks his fangs deep into your palm. You feel his curse spreading throughout your body as your strength starts to ebb away. At the same time, the snake grows stronger and starts to pulse with a faint light. You drag your hand back before the very last of your vigor slips away, and you stand hunched over and gasping for breath. The gentle glow within Vrogir grows brighter until you struggle to look at him. The god bursts into yellow flame, searing its way through the log. Vrogir transforms again, standing before you in his true orcish form, before snorting in derision and walking away. The vision slowly fades, and you are back in the temple, the smell of damp death filling your nostrils. You see that a crude sun pictograph has been hacked into the altar's rock. The altar sits before you, defiantly silent. The crocodile remains slumped.
My...
What strange contraptions are these?
The ghost stares right through you, a horrified look upon her face.
They took the realm. They took it all. But they don't know what it is. They don't know what they have.
Hope flashes in her eyes as she tries to focus upon you.
Those black ring dogs. They took the universe. But they don't know what it is. I pray they do not think to try to use it.
She turns away.
Lucky find.
An empty pedestal stands before you. From the ostentatious nature of the carvings upon it, you can tell it once used to hold something of great value.
Something's missing here, something valuable.
Thank you.
to see here. Please move along. I know it's doomed. All will die, and all will fall to ruin. You bring chaos here. You bring death. Leave me out of it. Leave me be.
I've spotted something. Thank you.
The automaton doesn't react to your... The automaton doesn't react. The automaton doesn't... The automaton doesn't react to your...